I've been on YouTube for almost 8 years now, and it's been no secret that I am a huge hockey fan. But writing good hockey movies is not usually a rarity of things nowadays. I mean, the first one that came out was The Mighty Ducks. It came out the year I was born, in 1992. And I thought the first film was okay. But probably the most everyone fan favorite was D2. And this movie inspired me on to become a hockey player. The reason why I prefer this movie over the original is because it had a lot of good hockey action, as well as the Honda Center in this first video. Now that's a nice bit of trivia right there. And it had a really good villain of Team Iceland. And that player's name is Gunnar Stahl. This guy is what I wanted to be a hockey player to be like. Because when I first saw Gunnar play in the movie, I was like, man, maybe I could be as good as that. But who knows, maybe it'll happen someday. But after doing some longful consideration, we're going to bring Gunnar Stahl back to life in NHL 17. And here comes the...
Hey guys, Mike here. Yes, by that intro I made several weeks ago, it's time to create Gunnar Stahl in the Be A Pro series. For this one, I'm going to be using something a little different with this one. Last time I sent him to the Quebec Ramparts, which I will probably use in 2K8 and NBA NHL... NHL 18, there we go, had to get that out. And once again, yes, I'm not watching SmackDown Live, sue me. Just because of one thing. And here's the thing, for those people asking, if John Cena wins the title, which, honestly, because rumors haven't, I think right now, it's been almost been speculated, as of right now, the way John Cena's acting, I do think they're probably leaning towards a double turn. Because if they do a double turn, that will not only at the same time, keep viewers intrigued of John Cena's character. Well, if he loses and then turns heel, that's fine. That is fine. And that's fine. I love that this mascot's names are in here, too. Alright. There we go. And there's that. The only thing... Alright. Gonna make him a youngster. And yes, guys, I am doing a season mode, which I did a recording of it last night, but we're gonna add a couple more characters to add to the mix. One will be based off the Mighty Duck movies, which will be the first one you're going to see, and I have to add more characters to that. You probably know where that's going. There we go. Alright, there we go. No beard. Now, equipment, the only thing we're changing is the helmet. Everything else is practically fine. There we go. Oh, and I just realized I to go to the details. We're gonna make up a birthday. August 2nd, there we go. Barnaby, we're gonna make him from Iceland. But since Iceland's not in the actual game database, which is pretty... No, not Italy! I'm a stupid idiot. I swear I'm gonna make the list of Jericho in a couple weeks. He was raised in Iceland, but he lives in... This is a tough call. I guess we can go for the Czech Republic, a place of origin, but he's from Iceland. Alright, there we go. Now, goal celebration, we're gonna go with something kind of unique. And stop me where you've seen this before. That doesn't look good.
Let's see.
What the? Oh, please. Oh, come on. Are you serious? Now, I saw one that had the dab. I think that would be perfect for him. Let's see, where is it? Where's the dab? Where's the dab? Let's see, it's... Let's see. Let's see. Oh, there it is. There we go. Let's go with that. And there we go. There's that creation of Gunner Stall. Now for this one, it's obvious we're going to do the Memorial Cup route. Except this time we're going to use Quebec Major because that's what I used last time. Last time I used the Titan. Well, actually, no, I didn't. Actually. And no, again, I'm not using them for my characters this time around either. But we will show off their uniforms in this game as well. But for this one, whew, there's actually a team in here I actually like. And I have never thought in a million years, I can't believe I forgot about these guys. Of course, that team I'm referring to is... the team that I feel... could very well be being a player that could be drafted by this team in the very near future. And that is, of course... I still have to make a decision. Actually... yeah, Olympiques. I don't know. Actually, you know what? Let's go to Drummondville. Yeah, let's send Gunner to Drummondville. That seems like a fun. And there it is. Experience will be medium. Alright, guys. See you guys in the game. Alright. Here we go. Here's the Gunner Stall in a... Drummondville uniform, the Fortiers. If I mispronounced it, I apologize. Which, and by the way, that is an epic logo right there for Drummondville. Alright, time to take on Cale Haig, Clegg, and the Brandon Wheat Kings. We're going to use the home jerseys for this one. And by the way, my Star Wars Land update will be... Alright, here we go. Let's get started. Here we go. And there's Jordan Papperty, and there's our goalie, Anthony Dumont-Bouchard. What? I'll be right back. Alright, sorry about that. Let's begin. Drummondville versus Brandon. Take two. And I'm not gonna even bring up the first take. Here comes Gunner! Shut! Oh, whoa. Oh, I was hoping for a quick goal. And here comes the Voltigiers. On the draw. Gounet gives it the slight. Slight to Gounet. Gounet lost it to Stahl. and a shot say. And box off gives it to Gunnar. Gunnar, shot, score! And wait a minute! Portageurs! What? Can we get a better look at that? How is he not near that? That is treason! Thanks for screwing us over, you stupid ref. You know what? You just made the list! Goalie interference, my foot! Well, actually, to be fair, it kind of did look like it, I guess. So, again. Here comes Light. The stall! Save! Rebound! And there's Kale. The big part of the Los Angeles Kings future. If he keeps up what he's doing in Brandon. And by the way, for those who are wondering, Brandon's in Manitoba. And he was the Kings' first pick in last year's draft. And oh, icing. No! Shot. Going ahead. Gives it to Carcone. I should have gone back. Dang, Nabbit. Save by Marchand, and that is gonna be a... Alright, let's see how things go. 8:13 left, no score between Drummondville and Brandon. Here comes Carcone. Carcone, the stall! Save me by Parsiani. I can't even pronounce it. I'm sorry if I botched. Here comes Gunner. Let's see if Gunner can get something going here. Shot. Oh, Papernay got it. .306. So far, everything's been pretty much even between Drummondville and Brandon. Bob Koff gives it to Slight. Slight gives it to Carcone. Carcone to Bokoff. Bob Koff. And Carcone, the slide shot saved by Papernay. Two minutes left to go in the period. All right, and I think that's going to be the end of the period for Gunner. Yep, at the end of one, no score. That is hilarious. Ugh, that goal. Be right back, guys. Okay, I would do the traditional box score for events, but yeah, nothing. All right, let's just head to the second. Alright, here we go. Drummondville versus Brandon. Second period. On a draw, blocked by Carcone. Here comes Gunnar Stahl. Gunnar's on the move, trying to get it in. Oh, and a save by Parkinen. How is that bad aim? Come on. Here comes Drummondville. Drummondville shot scores! Gunnar Stahl gets a goal, and this time he gets to keep it. 1-0, Drummondville! What a beautiful play. And it knocked the water bottle off. And that was the... The Voltigeurs. Okay, now I think I can get the pronunciation. Here comes Gunnar Stahl once again. Here comes Gunnar! Shot save made by Pippini. Uh-oh. Don't. Ugh, blocked. Okay. Wait, you wanna go? Here comes Gunnar Stahl. This like gets it to Carcone. Shot saved by Frappardy. The vault is yours. Here we go. Shot. Carcone shot. Blocked. Alright. 7:58 left. Still 1-1 in favor. Still tied at 1. What the heck? Shot save again, save by Bouchard. Oh, watch. What's good? Shot, here comes Gunner! Shot. And there's the cover. Oh, man, this is ridiculous. And uh-oh. Yeah, all right! Drummondville gets another goal. That scared me, because every time there's a goal sim- Oh! Oh, sorry. 1 minute. Jump Gunner! Save made! Again! Shot! Oh! Save by Fabrini! Oh my god! This is great stuff between the Voltigeurs and the Wheat Kings! Yeah, I suck on the face-offs. And a shot save! Here comes Gunnar Stahl! Trying to get something going here! And oh! Committed a turnover! And at the end of 2... The Voltigeurs lead the Wheat Kings 2-1. Alright, see you guys in a second. Okay, third and final period. And I had to change chargers, so thankfully for the next one, as well as my future videos, we're gonna get that taken care of. Alright, there's the stats. And, oh, by the way, we gotta check who got the penalties. Oh, it's Wheaton and Matthews for that got the who got the Brandon goal and penalty respectively, and Aubrey got the then goal assisted by Graskamp and Slight. So Slight is having a hell of a game tonight. Get two assists, not bad. All right, let's seal the deal. Let's hopefully seal the deal. Otherwise, we're gonna be known as the choke artists of the first game of the Memorial Cup. And we still got Red Deer in London to deal with. Oh, that was pathetic. Okay. Oh, shot save made. Got a shot saved by Papperny. Alright. Let's see. 15:25 left to go in the game. And wait, what? All right, here we go. Shot save made. Oh, Kale. By the way, I'm going to do this right now. We're going to take a look at Kale Clegg. Because why not? Because he is a Kings prospect, and he is the future of this Los Angeles team, Kings team, even though they definitely need some help. But there's rumors that the Kings are interested in getting a Gabriel Landeskog, which personally, I would love if they could get Gabriel Landeskog, and that does not look like Kale. I'm sorry, that looks terrible. That looks terrible, EA. But there's also talk that they may get Matt Duchene. Trade rumors. There we go. Let's read a couple of these. What the? All these random trade bots. I'm kind of curious to see who they think we're gonna get. Okay, let's see. Well, who's the latest trade? Things here. Joel Laterra for the Blackhawks for Jonathan Taves. Matt Cullen for the Kings in exchange for Brady McNabb. No thank you. Cullen, he's getting up there. And I mean, don't get me wrong, McNabb is one of our worst defensemen But who knows? Maybe Matt Duchesne. Who knows? If we can get somehow can get both David Landeskog and Matt Duchesne, I think the future core of the Kings is in good hands. But let's be honest, Colorado's not going to do anything like that. And there we go. Oh! Here comes Gale. The slider shot score! And just like that, Sly gets on the goal sheet. 3-1 Drummondville. Gabriel Sly. And just like that, Drummondville's lead is up to 2. The biggest lead of the game. Now we gotta shut him down. Carcone. Just a slight back to Carcone. Carcone back to Stahl. He scores! And that's his second of the game. Gunnar Stahl. 4-1. Voltigeurs. He's gone. And now this is where they're going to start ramming up the points. I really wish, because the goal song they use is actually the same one that Columbus uses. It's a shame they couldn't get the horns into this game. Or the... lost control of the puck. Alright, let me take a look at... Oh, be right back, guys. I'm going to take a quick break. I'm going to cut the period in half here. Because we're getting... Okay. Bailey put to the Kings for Zach Sykov. That's funny, because Bailey's already on the Kings. Yep. Alright, let's get back to the game. Here we go, time for a line change. And at this point, the line. The game is just... This game is just about over. 3 minutes left to go. Here comes Gunnar. Whoops. Got a shot, save. Here comes Gunnar. Sean going for the hat trick. He's got it. A hat trick. 5-1 Drummondville. First, I got my first hat trick in this game. Finally. Look at that. And that's awesome. And the crowd is chanting for Gunner in those Voltigeurs jerseys. Wow! Wow! Look at this! Wait a minute, are they, they're not gonna review that! How they, wait a minute! How the hell? How the hell? Are they, I'll give them credit for, let's take a look, see. Yeah, it was right. It didn't actually go in it. Oh, wow. Wow. Okay, line change. And that is it. Drummondville, the Voltigeurs will beat Brandon 5-1. Voltigeurs get the victory. And there it is, that weird, the goal actually. Oh, actually went in on the first try. What do you know? 5-1. Wow. Wow, how did I miss the team play-by? I believe the face-offs definitely need some work. Oh, 3 stars. Gotta check that out. Gunner's number 1. Slight number 2. And Carcone got a 3rd star, or Carcone. excuse me, I'm just calling Carcone because of the accent. Just to be sure. Alright guys, so I'm going to take a quick 5-minute break. As the next game will be against the Red Deer Rebels. And I checked, there is an alternate for jersey. So we're going to have an all-black uniform game here tomorrow for next episode. So, thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe.